Forget for a moment that curious celebrity criminal Judy Moran, today found guilty of murder and who could well die in jail. Maybe more significant than Moran herself, for decades she's been part of a vicious and dangerous cycle of kill or be killed in Melbourne, the so-called underbelly of that city's society, its media and police life. And it seems the appetite for this stuff continues, unfortunately. Well, you might ask, how did this cold-blooded reality become mistaken for a cheap crime paperback or a successful TV cop show even? Or is it maybe the other way around? Here's 6pm's Maggie Palmer.
Drug dealers, murderers, criminals, but also celebrities. Australia has long had a macabre fascination with Melbourne's underworld.
You know, Australia's got a fairly long history of lionising criminals. I mean, you go all the way back to Ned Kelly, who murdered three police officers, and there's people still today who think because he wrapped a bit of tin round his head, he's someone to be held up and held in high regard.
Their life of excess, the personal drama and intrigue, all alluring to the public and the press.
Most of them live a life as though they are Hollywood gangsters, and so they appear like they're out of a movie. But ultimately, in most of these movies, the baddie ends up dead or in jail.
And today, that theory rang true, with the last Moran standing locked up. After a week of deliberating, a jury found 66-year-old Judy Moran guilty of orchestrating a hit on her brother-in-law.
Her relationship with Des was well known. She detested him, and he hated her.
The Moran matriarch's likely to spend the rest of her life behind bars because of a murder that took place here that she ordered in broad daylight in June 2009.
Des Tuppence Moran was shot dead in front of terrified locals in a Melbourne deli. She ordered his death fearing he was hiding millions of dollars from her. Today's the latest chapter in a bloody and colourful life for Judy Moran. Two of her partners were shot dead. Her two sons were also murdered, one killed in front of his children at a junior football game in 2003. Their killer was Carl Williams. He nicknamed himself the Premier of Melbourne's underworld. He was sent to jail, but was last year bashed to death.
Yes, it would have been nice to put a dagger straight through his heart.
Those who followed the long-running gangland saga say while today marks the end of a chapter, it's not the end altogether.
Now, the underworld wakes up to itself, goes underground, makes a lot of money, and then in a few years' time, we begin the cycle again. And it begins with a body in a car, body in a pub, body in a bush. The circle of life and the circle of death in the underworld.
Maggie Palmer in Melbourne.